Hey everybody, and welcome to the Mana Cave. My name is Ed.
My name is Steve.
And today, Steve and I are going to be playing Planeswalker Decks once again. It is the biggest loser. What are we calling this?
Best of the worst.
Best of the worst.
Best of the worst.
We are taking the two Planeswalker Decks that were released for the Aether Revolt set, correct? This is the first two planes, the first two of the first four Planeswalker Decks that were ever released. Now, we had battled out the regular Planeswalker decks against each other. And in the end, Ajani has never won and Chandra has never won.
That's right.
And Steve and I have not won a single Planeswalker battle because both times we came up against Travis and he just stomped us both. So
it's very sad.
This is going to be like the definitive loser as far as all... Not us.
Ed's going to be the definitive loser.
No. The of the Planeswalkers. It's either going to be a Johnny, which I will be playing.
Or Chandra, which I will be playing.
So,
she's got the hots for me.
Oh, God. Cut. So, we are going to now... We determined our opening hands. Neither of us mulliganed, right?
That's right.
Okay, so now we are going to play. And keep in mind, this is the third game we've actually recorded today. I've just been... had my ass kicked twice by Travis. So I'm slightly on tilt. Steve's coming in fresh.
Fresh as a daisy.
So if Steve wants to play like a psychology game, he should just screw with my head a bit. And I'm on the edge. I'm on the edge at this point. Anyways, we will start off, I guess. Oh no, we got to determine who's going to play first.
Who's going to go first?
Now, normally you determine your opening hand after you figure this out, but we do it differently on the Mana Cave.
Oh.
What did you get? Five?
Five.
I got six.
Yeah. You're gonna have to wait a little bit longer to
it's all
to
it's
lose.
All changing. It's all changing, folks.
It's all changing.
Somehow managed to put all my cards back on upside down. What am I at? Five?
Are we gonna start showing our opening hands all the time now?
Yeah, you know what? Go for it. You show it to the camera.
No.
You're showing it to the table camera.
That's right.
Okay. Let me know when you're done.
I think I'm done.
Okay.
Beware of reflection.
Reflections? Oh, I see. Oh, that's right, too. Okay, so there we go. And that is... Let me fan that out a bit more. That is my opening hand. So, I get to play first, right?
Yes.
Okay, wonderful, wonderful. I'm going to play a Plains. I'm going to tap that sucker and bring out Renegade Map. It's an artifact. Renegade Map enters the battlefield tapped. Sacrifice Renegade Map. Tap. Sacrifice Renegade Map. Search your library for a basic land card. Reveal it. Put it into your hand, then shuffle your library.
Oh, no, you didn't.
Enters tapped. Steve?
Yes?
Your turn.
Okay.
Your turn, sir. You did not color coordinate your outfit with your Planeswalker deck.
No.
You're sporting green. You would be more suited for a Johnny here.
I would be.
Yes. And I always wear gray and black, so I'm good for anything.
I'm going to play Plains.
Okay.
And then psych you out. It's your turn.
Ooh, the psychological warfare.
I know, right?
Okay.
So complicated.
I'm going to then draw my card. I'm going to tap Renegade Map, sacrifice it. I'm going to search my library for a basic land card, reveal it, and then put it into my hand. I'm going to reveal a forest.
Ooh.
That's right. That's right. I really like Renegade Map. There's Renegade Map, and then there's Explorer's Map from, I believe, Zendikar, I want to say. And I've been playing around with Explorer's Map, but Renegade Map is a nice sort of, I guess, trade-off, I guess. Yeah. But
my favorite would be the Marauder's Map from Harry Potter.
Yeah. Okay. I deserve that for all the wrestling references I've ever made in this show. I completely deserve to get stymied by a Harry Potter reference, so... Is that the one where it's like, I solemnly swear I'm up to no good?
Yeah.
Score!
Redemption! Redemption.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. A lot of redheaded children.
There is.
They're all Weasleys, though, right? Like, somehow it's like, we'll make all the redheaded children who are wizards all from one family. It seems kind of weird.
Anyways. It is weird.
God, what a weird diatribe. Yes, I revealed this forest. I'm putting it into my hand.
Okay.
I'm now taking this forest and putting it onto the battlefield. That felt good. That felt so good. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to tap two and play Ajani's Comrade. It's a 2/2 with trample. At the beginning of combat on your turn, if you control an Ajani Planeswalker, put a 1/1 counter on Ajani's Comrade. Obviously, I don't control an Ajani's Planeswalker, so I'll just pass the turn to you instead.
Okay.
It also doesn't have haste, so I wouldn't have been able to go to the combat, and that wouldn't have been... Oh, no, just beginning of combat. I didn't even have to attack with it. If I had an Ajani out, never mind. You guys probably know the rules better than I do, so...
Alright, I will put down a mountain. I will tap two mana to cast Veteran Motorist,
boom,
which is a dwarf pilot.
Ooh.
When Veteran Motorist into battlefield, scry two.
Go ahead. I was going to say as a commentary, I love that card in draft. If I'm drafting red-white vehicles, getting that card is amazing. Keep in mind, I'm not a great limited player, so that might not be the case for everyone, but to me, I like it. Sorry.
Oh, it's all good. I scryed two. Keeping one on top and putting one below.
Cool.
Whenever Veteran Motorist cruise a vehicle, that vehicle gets +1/+1 until the end of turn. It is a very sweet little card.
Yes. Yes, it is.
And little is not a... Never mind. I almost went there.
It's not a
well-endowed motorist.
Comment on the...
On the race.
Stature of the Dwarvish race. Yes, yeah. Okay.
I'm good. Your turn. Okay.
I'm going to play planes. I'm going to tap two white and bring out Verdant Automaton. Now, there's been some debate in the past between us whether it's automaton or automaton. I say automaton just because I heard that. I used to say automaton, but now I say automaton because I heard someone else who was playing Magic say it that way. So whatever. And it is a 1/2 artifact construct. I can pay 3 and 1 blue and put a 1/1 counter on the automaton.
Hmm.
Now.
Do your worst.
I'm going to swing in with a Johnny's Comrade for 2.
I'll take that hit.
Okay. And Travis, you're not Travis. No. Travis is off camera, that's why I said that. Not because I don't know who you are.
No, it's all
right.
Steve.
Steve, your turn. Your turn, Steve. Sorry. Yeah.
All right.
It's been so long since we played on the Mana Cave. I forgot
it's been
who
ages.
You are.
Far too long. Far too long.
What was that you played?
I played a Plains.
Oh my goodness.
I'm going to tap both my Plains. To cast Trusty Companion.
Okay.
It's a hyena, a 3/2 hyena with vigilance. Trusty Companion can't attack alone.
Alrighty.
For the record, I do say automaton.
I did too. Yeah. I do too. Like I said, I saw someone playing it on camera, and they referred to it as the automaton, and I'm like, is that, have I been saying it wrong all this time?
I think they're wrong.
I do too, right? I know, right? But yeah. But then again, I also used to say like aether instead of ether.
Yeah. Well, we also say like roof instead of roofing.
And
anyway,
and we say, because we're Canadian, a boot instead of a bout, yeah. Which I have never heard anyone say other than when we're trying to make fun of how people say that we say a boot. Is it my turn?
Yes.
Oh, no tax. Okay, I was expecting a tax.
I know.
Full on expecting a tax.
A man of... A complicated man.
A man of few attacks.
I'm a complicated...
Okay, I'm going to play Tranquil Expanse. It enters the battlefield tapped, and that can be tapped for either green or white. I will then... I'm going to swing in with Johnny's Comrade. It's a 2-2 with trample.
I see. I'll block.
You'll block?
Trusty companion.
Okay, so move to damage?
Yes.
Damage goes through. They both die.
They both
correct. Now I'm going to tap two white and a green and bring out Solemn Recruit. It is a 2-2 dwarf warrior with double strike. It also has revolt. At the beginning of your end step, if a permanent you controlled left the battlefield this turn, put a 1-1 counter on Solemn Recruit. I'm now going to move to the end step and put a 1-1 counter on it.
You did that on purpose.
Yes. Yes, I did, sir.
Oh.
I am sneaky like that.
Oh, God.
And I'm going to then pass the turn to you.
The advantages of reading your cards ahead of time are endless.
Yes. Yes, they are. Yes. I do like playing blind magic every once in a while, where you just, you know, go by feel and then toss it out there, and then you figure out as it's played on the board.
I see.
Makes for bad plays, but you know, still, it's fun sometimes. Blind man's bluff. Magic. I'm going to shut up now.
All right. I'm going to tap two planes to cast Sky Skiff.
Okay.
It's a vehicle with flying.
Yes, indeed.
2-3 vehicle with a crew of one.
Yes. Now, before, because I know you're sort of not used to playing with vehicles, and right. we were discussing some of the rules, but this is one rule we didn't go over.
Okay.
If you were to crew that now, like right now with this... This would have summoning sickness, so this wouldn't be able to attack.
Okay.
Okay? Just so you know. You could use it as a blocker, obviously, in my turn, but there you go.
I did not know that the vehicles had summoning sickness.
Yeah.
Thank you for clarifying that.
No
before
problem.
Before I made a horrible mistake. Horrible.
No problem.
I will tap two more mana, a plains and a mountain, which... to cast a Speedway Fanatic, which is a human pilot. With haste.
Ooh.
Whenever a Speedway Fanatic crews a vehicle, that vehicle gains haste until the end of turn.
Well, it's as if that was planned in. It certainly wasn't. So, not, right. No, that would have been planned by you, but my description of summoning sickness and the vehicle was not planned. So.
Right.
Because I didn't know what you had in your hand.
No, you had no idea.
No.
None.
None. I feel like I'm hunching down really low this game. Sorry. That was...
Should I do it?
I'm willing to give you advice when it comes to certain things, but I'm not going to tell you to whether you should swing it or not. It's got flying, so nothing I can do can block it.
Hmm. Also, don't ask the aggro player if you should do it. Do it. I will crew this Sky Skiff.
Okay. All you have to do is tap this guy? There you go.
Yes. That's what I do. This guy crews this guy. This guy attacks you.
Okay. So that this does have to tap, though, as well, too, when you attack. It doesn't have vigilance. So I will be taking two, unless you have any other shenanigans, which I don't see you having, because...
I'm tapped out.
You're tapped out. Okay.
Tapped out.
So I take two.
Yes, you do, sir.
And I'm down to 18.
Okay. Tie game.
Yes.
Your turn, sir.
Okay. Okay, I'm going to tap four and cast Inspiring Roar. Put a 1-1 counter on each creature you control. So this is going to go up another one.
Oh, that's disgusting.
And remember, this is double strike.
I know.
And then I'm going to put a 1-1 counter on the automaton, or the automaton, whichever you want to say. Tomatoes, tomatoes. And I'm going to swing in with both of them. So this is a 4-4 with double strike,
mm-hmm.
And this is a 2-3 with not double strike, with With not double strike, which is a very weird keyword for them to have added in the game, just briefly.
I will block this guy here.
Block that one?
Yeah.
Okay. So, damage. First strike damage goes through first, so you take 4.
I do.
And then we can might as well skip to the second part of the damage. So these guys trade. Mm-hmm. And then you take an additional 4. So you take 8 in total.
Down to 10.
Down to 10. Okay, so then we move to the end step, and because something died, this goes up another 1-1 counter.
Sure.
Okay. Because the great thing about this is it's not come into play. It's at the beginning of your end step if a permanent you control left the battlefield this turn, put a 1-1 counter. A lot of the revolt ones are dependent on coming into the battlefield, but this one is just dependent on it happening. So, and pass turn to you. So now this is a 5-5 with double strike.
All right.
Can you see the time?
8 minutes.
Put down planes. I will tap all my mana.
All of it.
Cast Liberating Combustion.
Uh-oh.
Liberating Combustion deals 6 damage to target creature. You may search your library and or graveyard for a card named Chandra Pyrogenius. Reveal it and put that card in my hand. If you search your library this way, shuffle it.
My goodness. No one expects 6 damage out of nowhere.
I know, right? Oh. I'm so powerful.
That might be the definitive moment in this game where the tides have turned and I'm just SOL. It's possible.
Reveal it, right?
Yeah, reveal it. And then shuffle. Now, luckily, Chandra costs 6. And you've currently still only got 5 mana up. Or mana. Actually, not up, because it's tapped. So I know you can't... Well, you also tapped out. So unless you pick up a land, or have a land in your hand already, hopefully Chandra won't be hitting the board next turn.
Right. Just hit you with this guy.
Okay, so I take 2?
Yes, please.
So I'm down to 16.
Your turn, sir.
Alrighty. That is really not what I was hoping for. I'm going to play a tapped Tranquil Expanse, and I'm going to have to pass the turn to you. So now we're going to see if you play that all-important 6 land. Does he have it? Is he slow rolling me? Find out soon on the mana.
I will tap 3 planes to cast Renegade Freighter.
Uh-oh. That's not good. Now that's got a crew cost of 2. Yikes. This could be bad.
Yeah. Oh, do you want me to read it? Whenever Renegade Freighter... I think Travis made a video on this, right? He made fun of the train.
I don't watch Travis's stuff.
Yeah. whenever Renegade Freighter attacks, it gets +1/+1 and gains trample up to the end of turn. As you said, the crew is 2, and it's a 4/3.
Yeah. So it becomes a
crazy train.
It becomes a 5/4 when it attacks. So
that's right. I'll just hit you with this guy.
Can I suggest something, maybe?
Sure.
And keep in mind, I'm, not on Steve's side. I am battling him out. What I probably would do is crew this with that, and then you can swing in for 5.
It has because, something sickness.
But this, remember, what's the effect on this one?
Oh, whenever...
Gives haste, right?
For some reason, I had it in my head that it was only in the opening turn.
No.
Of his opening turn.
Oh, I'm just checking because we had a small horse walk by in the form of Travis's dog, and it sort of bump some wires. I'm just making sure the camera's still on. Okay.
I'll take your advice and hurt you more.
And then swing in 4-5.
Yes.
Okay, so then I take 11.
I appreciate that.
Yeah, it's no problem. Dude, I've been doing nothing but lose for weeks now. I have no problem.
He's being really hard on himself. Yeah, your turn, sir.
My turn? Okay. Okay. You still haven't been able to play that 6 land to get Chandra out, which is great for me. I've got a weird choice to make here. You know what? I'm going to tap everything. And I bring out Ridge Scale Tusker. When it enters the battlefield, put a 1-1 counter on each other creature you control. I don't control anything else now because you burned it all away. So I do have a 5-5 now, which is great. Hmm. And I'm going to pass the turn to you because I'm all tapped out.
I'll put down Stone Quarry.
Okay. Are you okay? Okay. Yes, he has his 6 land now, but it's a coming to tap land. That's what you. I was wondering what Travis was reacting. I thought he was being funny because it's like, but it does change the game. It does change the game.
Should I have snapped and like and went around the room 5 times?
It just doesn't change the game this turn. Thank goodness. So, Steve. What's your name again? Steve. Twice I forgot his name. We've only known each other for 10
We are both years? Bald, and now we're both wearing glasses, so...
No, I won't be mean.
Wait, who was that directed at?
I was going to say, it was Steve's bald by choice.
Wow.
But I stopped myself.
I'm going to bed.
I stopped myself.
Come on, Jack.
Shit.
Oh, God. Travis is off camera saying I'm very mean to him.
He's drinking my beer.
I guess I'll get this in the field.
Go for it.
Tap 3 and cast a Weldfast Monitor.
Yeah.
It's a artifact creature lizard. If I tap a mountain, he gains menace till the end of turn.
Cool.
Can you dig it?
I can dig it.
Okay. I will. I will crew my sky skip.
Okay.
And attack you with it.
So I'm going to be taking 2 then.
Yes.
Okay. I will accept the 2.
Okay.
So I'm at 9.
Yes.
Find 9. There we go. There's the 9. Okay.
That's my turn.
Yeah. Okay. Alrighty. I'm going to tap 1 green and cast Prey Upon. Target creature you control fights target creature you don't control. So the Ridge Scale Tusker will fight the Weldfast Monitor.
Okay.
So that does that go through?
That goes through.
Okay. So that dies. This lives, but it does have 3 damage on it.
Right.
And I will then swing in with the Tusker.
And we'll take the damage. Okay. 5 damage.
So you'll be taking 5, yeah.
Down to 5.
Okay. Then I'm going to pay 3, including 1 green, and bring out
Silkweaver Elite. It's a 2-2 with reach. When it enters the battlefield, if a permanent you control left the battlefield this turn, draw a card. A permanent I control did not leave the battlefield because it survived. So I will just simply pass the turn to you then, sir.
You seem reluctant for that turn.
I'm just pondering. Pondering.
Interesting game. It's close. It's close so far.
It's going to come down the wire. 5-9?
Yeah.
Two creatures, one creature, two vehicles.
There a video on that? One creature's no. Two girls, one cup. So
cups. Oh snap! That happened.
Oh poop!
Oh wow!
Reference to a 5-year-old meme
that should never, ever, ever be referenced again.
You know, this is one of the weird things with the mannequins, because we'll edit out certain curse words, right? But technically, referencing Two Girls, One Cup, though vastly worse than any curse word I can think of, is something that can stay in because we're not tech. It's such a weird. It's a farce. This show is a farce.
The world. In general.
Nah, just this show. Sorry, Steve. Now, you do, to remind the folks at home, have 6 mana, and I know you have a certain planeswalker in your hand. It's something to think about.
It is. But you do, Ed, have a 5-5. And Steve does have 5 health left.
I'm not telling him what to do.
No pressure on you, buddy. Not that this play could make or break the game or anything. No. Prey Upon, though. Oh, so good.
I wanted to use Prey Upon with the Solemn Recruit, because with Double Strike, it would have done first strike damage to something and got rid of it that way.
Actually, I didn't know that.
Yeah, it's the same sort of thing. Like, if it's fighting, that's how it works. If it's, like, if it deals direct damage, it's just sort of deals direct damage as well, too. But with fighting, it is another one where if it had lifelink, for example, lifelink would trigger. If it had death touch would trigger. So if you have 1/1 with death touch and you prey upon something, it'll still technically do that damage too, because they're doing their damage to each other.
Essentially, the combat damage happens without combat.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. Okay. Exactly. So it's like a fight outside of combat.
Wish me luck.
Good luck.
Tap 3 mana to cast Spearside Infiltrator.
Boom.
It's a 3/2 human rogue.
Okay.
When Spearside Infiltrator becomes tapped, it deals 1 damage to each opponent.
Yikes.
I'm going to crew my Renegade Freighter with my Speedway Fanatic and attack you.
Okay. Once again, this is just a minor rule issue. You crew, you just tap that?
Right.
And then you'd swing in for the attack, right?
So I like to do the thing.
No, that's fine, but they don't tap at the same time, though.
Yeah.
No. Okay. So yeah. That's the only reason why.
He's inside there, though.
That is true. That is true.
I'm just, if you have to remind them, just go home.
Fair enough. Fair. Okay.
Okay. So I'd be looking at 5 damage. Interesting. And you could have a way to buff. I mean, you still possibility of buff spells, right? Mm. You know what? I'm going to take it. Do we move to damage?
We move to damage.
Okay, so I'm at 4. Okay. Okay. Whew, alrighty. Interesting game.
Your turn, sir.
My turn. Alright, I'm going to...
Nope!
Don't do it. Don't do it. It's a mistake, Ed.
I'm going to tap four and cast Ajani's Aid. When it enters the battlefield, you may search a library for and or graveyard for a card named Ajani, Valiant Protector. Reveal it, put it in your hand. If you search your library this way, shuffle it. Sacrifice Ajani's Aid. Prevent all combat damage a creature of your choice would deal this turn. Okay, so now I'm going to search the old library. I'm always curious sometimes when you have to search for that one specific card, how far away you were from drawing it anyways. And in this case, okay, so there we go. So that's the Ajani Valiant Protector. And now I'm doing the required shuffling of the deck.
Okay, but at this point, it was at least 10 cards down, and in a 4 or 5 game, that's forever away.
Exactly. I never would have reached it otherwise. No. So.
Sacrifice Ajani's Aid.
Prevent all combat damage a creature of your choice would deal this turn. So I'm going to get you to cut my deck.
Yeah, that really messes with me.
Good.
So, can you like not do that?
The whole damn point. Now keep in mind, I'm in the same boat that you were. I'm only at 5 land, so I can't cast Ajani yet.
Right.
And in this case, I'm gonna pass the turn to you.
Okay.
I'm not gonna swing in this time. Whew. This is going to be an interesting game.
This has been a very good game.
Yeah, it's been a solid game. It's been a solid, solid game. Once again, if I lose, I may lose my mind, but... and that's a very real possibility at this point.
I'm going to... crew both my vehicles.
Okay.
And attack with both.
Now, I take one damage because you crewed with that one, right?
Yes.
Okay, so I'm down to 3. And you're crewing both your vehicles.
Yeah.
And that's flying, that one there.
That's flying. That one's trample.
Okay, I'm going to block the Sky Skiff.
Okay.
Because this has reach. I'm going to sack Ajani's Aid and prevent all combat damage from this creature here.
Okay.
So then we move to damage.
We move to damage.
This dies.
This dies.
Nope, that's still alive because that's a 2/3.
Right.
So.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, and I will cast an instant.
Okay.
If
you do 6 damage to my creature again, I'm going to...
I know, I'm going to do 4 damage directly to you.
Why wouldn't you just do that to begin with?
I didn't know it would work.
What? Okay, so then... Oh, so then I lose then, so... No, we're not flipping the table, don't worry.
We're good.
Congratulations. Why didn't you just do that to begin with?
Well, I honestly thought you'd have something, so I'd exhaust it all and then just do that.
That's not a bad play to someone exhaust their spells.
Yeah.
I don't know. What do you,
mean exhaust? I have one.
I don't know.
I have one
land
up.
I don't know.
I have one land up. He didn't even need to tap this to do the extra point of damage. He could have literally just cast that right off the bat.
I did.
Because... What's the worst that could happen if he did that first?
I don't know what you're having a hard hand. I don't know what your deck list is. I don't.
Okay. However, you still won.
Yeah.
Even though you could have won.
Target creature gains lifelink.
Pre-combat. So how do you feel? Now that... you know, and here's the thing. Not because you were playing it.
Yeah.
But I would have put Chandra's deck as being the biggest Planeswalker loser because I hated that deck when I played it. And I really liked Johnny's deck. So I'm surprised that Johnny ended up being the one that, and I hope it wasn't me.
Oof.
Jeez, I sure hope it wasn't me. So do you feel good?
I feel good.
That's what you had left in the.
I had her in my hand there.
So this is, she deals 2 damage to each opponent.
Yes.
Or you can -3 to deal 4 damage to target creature. And her -10 is deal 6 damage to target player and each creature he or she controls.
All right.
So I never got my Planeswalker out. You never got your Planeswalker out, though you had the mana for it.
Well,
so,
that would
but
be the
in
first
the
mana
end,
cave where the Planeswalkers didn't actually...
Neither of them. We got to see them. At least we got to see them. We got to know that they were there. So how do you feel now that you've...
I feel good.
Yeah.
I didn't know. Well. Yeah, I feel good. Thanks. Thanks for asking. Feel good. I'm not familiar with red. Red's a new thing for me, and it always feels a little awkward.
What was your nickname back in the day?
It's like wearing shoes on the wrong feet.
Well, you had a nickname back in the day. What was it?
Red. Yeah. Well, magic. Irony. It's a totally different ballgame. It's like a whole nother thing, right? Anyway, thank you for the game. It was really exciting.
Yeah. This is my sixth loss in a row on the Manicate.
Stop adding up the loss.
Well, it's not like they're on record on online anywhere.
No one but you is counting.
So, we'll find out. Next Mana Cave, we're going to be doing Amonkhet stuff. Yeah? Yeah? Yeah. Okay. So I thought you were like no, don't say that. We're not.
One of two things.
We're doing Fallen Empires.
Y'all. Unglued. We hit the lottery.
I'd play that.
Yeah. It would be either the Planeswalker deck.
Yes.
I think we could use a break from, but if we can manage the timing, it'll be...
Possibly the pre-release decks because at the very least, do you know if you're going to be able to go to the pre-release?
I will be there with bells on.
Are you going to be able to play this time?
Absolutely.
Okay, so
I'll be playing and it'll be really exciting.
So we are either going to be playing with the Planeswalker decks again, or we're going to be playing with the new Planeswalker decks, which is Gideon and Liliana, right? And or we're going to be playing with our pre-release decks on the Mana Cave. So I'm not sure which, but it's definitely going to be Amonkhet. So that's something you can look forward to.
We know and, standard. We're all up in there.
Oh, yeah.
And, Popper's a side thing.
Vegas odds, you can probably make a ton of money if you bet on me at this point to win. So keep that in mind for all you bettors out there. You know, because we know some of you live in Vegas. Hey, John. So, yeah, that is it for this episode of the Mana Cave.
That's it. That's it. Take care of yourselves. Thank you so much for joining us.
Oh, definitely take care of yourselves.
Yeah. Whatever you do.
We want you to be around for a long time. So take care of yourselves. And
we need you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
We'll see you all very soon. Right? Didn't mean that to be a question. We'll see you all very soon.
We'll see you all very soon. Bye bye.
So I'll start it off.
Human torch touchdown in Tucson today.
Lion face. Ooh, lion face.
Oh, please, by all means.
Okay.